Good morning. Charlie O'Hara in the studio. If you have a legal question you would like to have answered, give us a call, 436-1212. Charlie, I feel like you and I have been missing each other the past few weeks. Good to have you back in the studio.
Good to be here. Hopefully it's going to get warm. And
I know we are having a warm-up on the way. Good news.
The 30s is great.
Exactly. It feels good compared to zero.
That's right.
We're going to okay, we've got a couple of calls on the line. Let's get right to that. Hi there. You're on the line with Charlie. What's your question?
Hello?
Hi, go right ahead. You're on the line with Charlie.
Yeah, this is Jeremy. I just got out of Sedgwick County Jail, right? I was in the trustee pod, and I have like $800 worth of trustee hours, and I was curious if it wouldn't go towards like my driving on suspended and stuff like that.
Well, yeah, that is possible. And what he's talking about is there's different levels of custody when you're in the jail. The trustee custody is one where you take help do things in the jail. You'd clean up the jail. Maybe somebody that cooks the food, cleans up the food, do different things for the guards and stuff. Sometimes even answer the phone when people are calling for certain information. And you can work and do that, and then you get credit as being a trustee, and then you can ask the judge to take that credit that you've got, in this instance over $800, and apply that to the fine that the judge gives you. So if someone doesn't have any money, that's a way for them to work and actually get some money to pay a fine. So what he needs to do is he needs to have his attorney or himself, if he doesn't have an attorney, ask the judge to credit that to any fine that he would get.
Okay, good advice. Thank you, Charlie. Uh-huh. Great question. We're going to go ahead and get back on the phones. Hi there, you're on the line with Charlie. What's your question?
Yeah, on that new law pertaining on same-sex marriage and all that, because I'm in the motel industry, I'm wondering, you know, why we even need it when, like, right here at the business itself, we have a right to refuse service to anyone.
Well, you know, I don't know how that's going to play out. I mean, that's Kansas is an unusual state. We have the federal thing that just came down a couple of days ago, evidently something from the Justice Department having to do with how the federal courts are going to recognize same-sex marriage. However, this state has a state constitutional amendment that bans same-sex marriage. So how that's all going to play out, we don't all know as attorneys. That hasn't been done. The trend in the United States appears to be that the federal courts are overruling the state laws and they're allowing same-sex marriages in states. I don't think that, depending on the circumstances, I have to research it, I'm not sure you can refuse someone to come into your establishment on that basis. But I'm not sure about that yet because it hasn't all been straightened out.
Okay, we'll see in the next few months then, perhaps.
Maybe years on that one.
Okay, thank you, Charlie. Uh-huh. We're going to go ahead and get to our next caller. We have one more on the line. Hi there, you're on the line with Charlie. What's your question? Hi there, go ahead, you're on the line.
Me and my wife got a divorce, but in our divorce, she took her car and I took my car. But,
yes.
But I co-signed on her car, and now they're coming after me for the money. And is there any way I can get out of paying that?
Well, the way that works is if you both sign the loan, the judge will say who's supposed to pay the loan. That order from the judge doesn't affect the mortgage or the bank or whoever is financing that. So if she doesn't pay, you have to owe it. You owe it and you have to pay the bank, or it's going to affect your credit. However, you can go back to court and ask that she be held in contempt for not doing what the judge said. But if you sign a note and your ex-spouse or your spouse doesn't pay it, or anybody, and you sign it, then you're responsible for it. So you should pay it and then get an attorney or to yourself and go back to court and have her held in contempt and get a judgment against her.
Okay, great advice. Okay. Thank you, Charlie. Mm-hmm. We'll see you next time.
Okay, thanks.
Enjoy the warmer weather.
Oh, I'm glad.
We'll be back with more Eyewitness News in just a few minutes on KSCW. Stick with us.
Expect more on KSCW. This is Eyewitness News This Morning in high definition. Online at kwch.com. Follow KWCH on Facebook and Twitter.